Hey everyone, welcome back to my greenhouse. My name is Joe. Have you ever asked yourself why cacti actually have spines? There's four good reasons, really. Reason number one, and it's probably a quite obvious one, spines keep predators away, so they offer protection. Reason number two, spines actually help cacti collect water. Especially in areas of heavy fog or morning dew, they will draw the moisture out of the air and water will actually often run towards the plant bodies, down the sides and towards the roots in the ground. Reason number three, cactus spines provide shade to the main stem, the main plant. So often when you look at cacti, although these individual spines appear to be, you know, quite thin, and you'd think that's not going to actually create a lot of shade, but it's the mass that, taken together will actually protect the sensitive stem and its outer skin, the epidermis, from direct sunlight. A thick coating of spines, that's going to be a really effective protection against scorching desert sunlight. And the fourth reason may be surprising. Spines trap air and they protect the plant from losing water. So they reduce the airflow and the evaporation around the cactus itself. And the trapped air between the spines creates an insulating buffer zone. And this protects against evaporation and heat during the hot daytime, but also during the cold nights in the deserts. This buffer zone actually insulates and creates a very nice protecting layer against cold temperatures. There you go. I hope you found that useful. The four key reasons why cacti have actually developed spines throughout millions of years of evolution and how that has helped them adapt to the harsh desert environments that they generally live in. And finally, here's another amazing fun fact for you at the end of this video. Did you know that today's sharp pointed cactus spines were once fleshy leaves on the predecessors of today's cactus plants? These former leaves have modified themselves to hard, prickly spines over millions of years of evolution, as these former and distant relatives of the cactus plants gradually adapted themselves to the drier and hotter desert environments in northern, central, and southern America. Also, if you'd like to know more about how also some other well-known plants besides cacti adapted themselves to similar hot, dry environments, even on other continents, and how they too became somewhat similar-looking prickly succulent plants, albeit completely unrelated to cacti, well then please check out my other topical videos on this channel. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, I'd really appreciate if you clicked a like, or even better, if you subscribed to my channel. Hope to see you again soon. Take care and happy growing.